Hello, wonderful people! It's Genevieve, and my goal here on this channel is to teach you all about illustration and design. So if you're new, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of the weekly videos, and so that you can join our wonderful creative community. Today, we're going to learn how to create two different cut shape or text effect in Procreate, however you want to call it. We're going to have one that looks like the text or the shape is above, and then one that looks like there's a hole in the sheet of paper or something like that. And I did include a little bonus in this video. Towards the end, I'm going to show you how you can add a paper texture. It's totally free. But for now, we're just going to start with this above effect. So go ahead and make sure that your shape is on a separate layer. If it's actually text, you're going to need to rasterize it so it's not text anymore and it's just a bunch of pixels. So to do that, mine is already rasterized, but you would just tap on your text layer and select rasterize. It's towards the middle of the list right here. So once you have that, you need to change your text or your shape or whatever to the background color. So go ahead and color pick the background color, and then you're going to drop your color onto your shape, making sure it fills everything. So here I have separate shapes. So you're just going to adjust the threshold as you need so that everything gets filled in. And to adjust your threshold, in this case, you're probably going to need to only increase it. You would move your finger towards the right. There we go. So at this stage, you should not be able to see anything. So we're going to go ahead and temporarily hide the background color. And then we're going to create a copy of our shape. So we're going to go ahead and duplicate the layer. So you can just swipe it towards the left with one finger and then tap on duplicate. For now, we can just hide the top one, and making sure the bottom one is selected, we're going to make our color a little bit darker. Now, how much darker is totally up to you, but make sure it's at least dark enough so you can see that there's a difference there. So once you have your darker color, same thing, we're just going to fill in the shape. And then you can reactivate the top layer. You're then going to select the arrow tool here at the top. And you're going to move your bottom layer a little bit towards where you want your shadow to be. Now, once that is done, you can go ahead and reactivate your background, and you're going to see the effect start to take place. We're going to fine tune it a little bit. So with the bottom layer selected, which is the darker one, you're going to go in the adjustment menu and selecting Gaussian blur. Now you're just going to add a little bit of blur, so for that you can take one finger and swipe it towards the right, which as you can see is going to add blur. Now the amount here really depends on just the effect you want to achieve. You could have a lot of blur or very minimal blur. So that's it for the above effect. Now on to the hole effect, which is a tiny little bit more tricky, so make sure you pay attention here. We're going to start once more by just recoloring the shape or the text that we have so it matches the background. So I'm going to reactivate my hole here. So just color picking the background color and then dropping it onto the shape and filling everything. So once more, we won't see anything, so we're going to temporarily hide the background. And this time we're going to create three versions of this layer. So just duplicating it twice, and there we go. Now, just like for the above, we're going to make one of the version darker, so it's the shadow, but this time it's going to be the middle version. So you can go ahead and hide the top one, and with the middle selected, going back to a darker version of your background color. You might still have it in your history if you practice with the above version, but otherwise, just make it darker manually. And then fill in your shapes. Now you can go back and reactivate the top shape, selecting it, and with the arrow tool, moving it a little bit. Now the trick here is that we need to make sure that the light part stays within the dark section. So to do that, we're going to apply this top layer, which is the light one, as a clipping mask on the dark one. So just tapping on it and selecting clipping mask. And now it should look a little bit more like a hole, but still we have the same problem we had with the above effect, which is this kind of shadow looks really, really harsh. So still with the light layer selected, the one at the top, the one that is as a clipping mask, you're going to go in your adjustment panel and going back to Gaussian blur, you're going to add some blur here as well. Now, if you feel like your shadow is a little bit too big, you always have the option to just move the top layer to reduce the shadow. So at this stage, you can go ahead and reactivate your background layer, and you should see that it created a hole. And we're going to bring this effect to the next level by adding a little bit of a thickness to the hole. So for that, go ahead and hide the top two layers, as well as the background, so you only have the bottom one here, which for now should still be the same color of the background. So you can color pick your color, and this time we're going to make it lighter. You can then fill the shape. Reactivate the background and the two other layers. And then zoom in quite a lot, ideally on an angular shape. So not like a curve like the O, but really a nice angle. And here with the arrow tool, you're going to move this light layer a little bit, just a few pixels up, which is going to create this really nice little thickness effect. And if you feel like it's too intense, you always have the option to just slightly lower the opacity of this layer. Now, if you want this effect to look like paper, you're going to need some sort of a texture. So I included one that you can download in the description below. It's totally free, so it's a paper texture sample. And once you have it downloaded, just go ahead and select the layer at the very top of your list, no matter what it is. And then go in the wrench icon menu and select in the add submenu, insert a photo. You're then going to have to locate the texture that you downloaded. And once you have it, just tap on it, which is going to import it in your file. And quick note here, depending on how you downloaded the picture, it's actually possible it is not saved on your iPad as a picture, but it might be saved as a file. So if that's the case, instead of selecting import a photo, just select import a file and then go in your downloads folder. It should be right there. Then you can just tap on it and follow along with the rest of the steps. You're probably going to have to resize it. So just using your arrow tool, resizing it as you want. And then in order to have the texture and not just a white rectangle, you're going to go and tap on the little N next to the check mark and change the blending mode to linear burn. You can of course change the opacity of this layer to have more or less texture as you want. But if you zoom in, you can see that now we have a little bit of grit in the image. And if you enjoyed this video and want to learn more Procreate tips and tricks, I highly recommend you check out this playlist because I have a bunch more for you. But before you leave, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly videos I post every Tuesday and Saturday. Then click on the link right here, and I'll meet you there.